A year ago, last Thursday, I was strolling in the zoo when I met a man who thought he knew the lot. He was laying down the law about the habits of baboons and the number of quills a porcupine has got. So I asked him, "What's that creature there?" He answered, "It's a helk." I might have gone on thinking that was true. If the animal in question hadn't put that chat to shame and remarked, "I ain't a helk. I'm a gnu. I'm a gnu. I'm a gnu. The gnicest work of gnature in the zoo. I'm a gnu. How do you do? You really ought to know who's who. I'm a gnu. Spell G-N-U. I'm not a camel or a kangaroo. So let me introduce, I'm neither man or moose. Oh, gnu, 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 I'm a gnu." I had taken furnished lodgings down at Rustington-on-Sea, whence I traveled on to Ashton-under-Lyme. And the second night I stayed there, I was wakened from a dream, which I'll tell you all about some other time. Among the hunting trophies on the wall above my head, stuffed and mounted, was a face I thought I knew. A bison? No, it's not a bison. An okapi? I don't think it's an okapi. Could it be a hearty beast? When I seemed to hear a voice. "I'm a gnu. I'm a gnu. A another gnu. I wish I could gnash my teeth at you. I'm a gnu. How do you do? You really ought to know wahoo's wahoo. I'm a gnu. Spell G-N-U. Call me bison or okapi and I'll sue. Nor am I in the least like that dreadful hearty beast. Oh, gnu, 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 I'm a gnu. Gnu, 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 I'm a gnu. Gnu, 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 I'm a gnu.